Let's get right into things today because I want to show you a test hack for the rhetorical analysis essay that will make handling this task much, much easier for you. Remember, AP doesn't actually stand for agony and pain or anxiety and pressure. It actually stands for answer the prompt. In order to answer the prompt, you need to be able to critically read the prompt. If you can, you'll be able to approach the rhetorical analysis task with much greater confidence. In order to show you how to break down the prompt, I'm going to be using the publicly released 2015 question 2 from the AP Lang exam. Of course, it's in the description. This is the actual prompt that goes along with the Cesar Chavez reading that my other recent rhetorical analysis videos center around. There are 4 steps in this process, the first 3 of which are quite easy. And the last step isn't necessarily hard, but it does require some critical thought. So let's get to it. In just a minute, you're gonna see the prompt show up on the screen. Give it a quick read, and then I'll show you exactly what you wanna do to get the most out of it. Hint, what I'm about to show you must be done before you read the essay that the prompt relates to. So we break down the prompt first. On test day, you want to go through this process before addressing the reading and writing your essay. I'm going to use a graphic organizer to go through the steps with you, and you can find that in the description too. But on test day, you're not going to have this graphic organizer, so you want to make sure you know the steps. The first step in the process, which is one of the easy steps, is identifying the tagline in the prompt. Tag stands for title, author, and genre. It's typically easiest to identify these things in this order, but you'll notice pretty quickly that there is no formal title given in this particular prompt. Because of this, we're actually going to skip the title for the moment and just label the author and the genre. The author, Cesar Chavez. The genre, article. Since we definitely need to call the reading something when we write our essay, we're gonna have to create a title. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna combine the author and the genre and the audience so we can do this. So we're just gonna call it Cesar Chavez's magazine article for a religious organization. All that information was taken right from the prompt. We're not gonna put quotes around it or anything though because it's not a formal title. Now we're going to move to the second column that has us searching for important background information. We're gonna identify elements of the rhetorical situation that may show up in the prompt. Here we wanna mark things like the article was published on the 10th anniversary of Martin Luther King Jr.'s death. Cesar Chavez was a labor union organizer and a civil rights leader. And the magazine was for a religious organization that was dedicated to helping those in need. Don't think that the prompt will necessarily tell you what the purpose is, though sometimes that information does show up. But all of this will allow us to begin making inferences that will help us read the essay later and read the essay more effectively. Step 3 is going to be identifying what I call the command element of the prompt. All we need to do is identify what we are actually commanded to do in the essay. And that's easy because we are actually commanded to analyze the rhetorical choices that Chavez makes to develop his argument about nonviolent resistance. So we start with the word analyze and then we just end at the end of the sentence. That's what we're commanded to do. But does the prompt ask us to identify? No. Summarize? No. Explain? Uh-uh. We have to analyze, and that verb requires more than the 3 other verbs I just mentioned. So, to find the command, we're just gonna copy what we were commanded to actually do. Analyze the rhetorical choices that Chavez makes to develop his argument about nonviolent resistance. By the way, that reminds me. Have you been watching my videos and you haven't subscribed yet?
Stop it. Get some help.
All you need to do is click both the subscribe button and the like button, and you'll have all the assistance you need to do well in your English class. All right, step 4. And this is for all the marbles, the big cheese, the jackpot. What we've done until now has required no inferential reading. We've just had to identify parts of the prompt. This last step requires us to generate what I call the conquer question. What this means is that we actually transform the prompt into a question that will allow us to focus our reading on the text and our writing of the essay. In essence, it allows us to conquer the entire rhetorical analysis task, reading and writing alike. Here's how you do it. You're gonna look at your command and you wanna find the infinitive in it. That's the word to, followed by an action verb. In this particular case, it's that language that says to develop. We're gonna draw a line to the left of the word to, and then we're only going to look at the language to the right of that word. This is important. Don't look to the left of that line. You'll be distracted by the language that's there. We need to stick to the language that's just at the end of the command. Now, with only the language to the right of that line, we're gonna ask a question that starts with the word what. You absolutely must ask this question with the word what, not why, not how. It must be what. And the reason why is because the word what creates the easiest type of question to answer. And we're trying to make this task easier. And now I'm gonna look at each word that shows up to the right of the word to, and I'm gonna ask, what can't I know before I read the essay? Can I know that Chavez is trying to develop an argument? Yes, it says so right here. Can I know that his argument is about nonviolent resistance? Yes, it still says so right here in the prompt. Can I know that the author is a male because this is a male pronoun? Yes. But can I know what Chavez's argument about nonviolent resistance is yet? No. So that's what we want to read for. That's the only thing you need to figure out by the time you're done the essay. You don't need to focus on rhetorical choices. Why? Because we are going to figure out the meaning first and we'll find the choices later. What is Chavez's argument about nonviolent resistance? That's our focus. The reason why this is so helpful is because if you can answer this question by the time you've finished reading the piece, everything will fall right into place. You know exactly what you're looking for. Once you figure out the argument about nonviolence that he wants the audience to understand, you can then make a judgment about what the audience should do based on their understanding of the argument that he's projecting. Then all you need to do is just find the textual evidence that revealed the argument to you while you were actually reading and explain how what Chavez does in those pieces of text reveals this argument to his audience and moves them to act how he wants. So while we read, we found his argument, found the text that allowed us to realize that's what his argument was, then said what he was doing in those pieces of text, and there's your paper. This whole task is meant to keep you focused and not treasure hunting for rhetorical devices. Because remember, in this essay, you need to write about rhetorical choices. This process will help you in identifying meaningful textual evidence and rhetorical choices and bring the whole thing together. Now, if you want to see how to write a rhetorical analysis thesis statement that is meaningful, you're going to want to like this video, subscribe to the Garden of English, and then check out this.